This was kind of a special event for us because we have in the past attended FanX, but this year we got to actually be there in a booth. We were at the Evermore booth alongside our good friends Quincy from Quincy's Tavern and Jason from Critical Dice. And we were there helping to kind of promote Quincy's big event that he has going on in Pleasant Grove, Utah, in May of 2023. And so we were there kind of helping promote that, but also there to meet some of our followers, people that we were able to see in person, which was really exciting. And we got to have a panel with Quincy, Jason, and Harley, where we sat and talked about content creating and how to get rid of your limiting beliefs and kind of get through the standard of social media being kind of a toxic place that it can be, and making the positive best out of certain situations. So that's kind of why we were there.
I think the most surreal moment at FanX was the fact that it was really happening. Up until this moment that we were there meeting people physically, we had been talking to a phone for literally 10 months. We'd been talking through a phone to everyone that we've met. We've run into a few people at Evermore every once in a while, and that was a reassuring moment. But there were so many people that came to us and said we've impacted them, said that we've changed a lot of their life, their perspective. There were a lot of people that came to us and asked us questions on how to better their social media. And it was amazing to feel like a resource, and to also feel like all the work that we have personally done together to help others has truly paid off.
It was like a real thing. Yeah. No, I agree with that one completely. For me, honestly, I think the fact that seeing people's faces and the impact that we've had on them is what is constantly in my head. You know what I mean?
Yeah, when people like would spot us from across the room, even sometimes point at us, jump up and get giddy. Mm-hmm. Like, we were so excited to meet those people. It was like a game of roulette. Quite frankly, I didn't expect very many people to do so.
Same.
The most cherished memory for me personally was when Quincy met our children for the first time.
That was cute.
Yeah. When Quincy met our children for the first time, he had so much energy with them, and they can tend to be a little shy when they're meeting people for the first time. But Quincy opened them up. Our daughter, Maple, was just so talkative with him, and he went down to their level, and it was just...
Maple keeps talking about when she gets to see Quincy again. It's very cute.
It was so rewarding to see.
Yeah. Anything that I realize about myself through this is that my impact as a mother is a lot more than I thought it was. My impact as a parent, because seeing some of these, you know, people out there that came to us and said, you are more of a parent figure to me than my own parents, that is what, I mean, made a huge realization that, like, me as a parent is a lot bigger than I thought. Like, huge.
I think the other thing that I'd like to add as well was how inspiring we were to people as a couple. Quite frankly, you and me personally have been through a lot of trials and errors and resolves, but you and me are absolutely comfortable with one another. We love each other truly through and through, and seeing how we've impacted other couples and relationships. I mean, we're just living our everyday life. Like, you and me on this camera, on this app, is just us. Truly is us. And us being ourselves, inspiring other people.
But through characters.
But through characters who we're comfortable with, has been really amazing to see. And we've learned a lot about how us as a strong couple, according to these people we've met, has influenced couples to be stronger.
Yeah.
So I come from a background of stage performing. I've been in many stage productions and musicals, and even some TV stuff. But with that said, there's always the jitters before standing in front of an audience. The difference is, whenever I did stage performing, I had a script I ran by, and I went straight off of that, and I was able to have a fourth wall in front of me the whole time. In this instance, we had no fourth wall in front of us. We were facing the people, the audience, which was a massive audience, to say the least. And we had to answer questions on the fly, improvise, in a way, who we are and our experiences. And it was very, very, very stage fright inducing, I guess you could say, from my end.
From my standpoint, the second we got there, we went to check out our panel room because we wanted to see how big it was. And when I took a look in there and went, wow, we guesstimated 400 people would be sitting in that room. And, you know, it scared me. Made me poop my pants. I have really, really, really bad social anxiety from claustrophobia. And so for me, this fear, this hindrance that I have with claustrophobia and big crowds, every single time we go to Comic Cons, I break down in tears. And so this was something really scary for me, even though I had a little bit of stage acting, not as much as Seth. It scared me half to death. And I really had to, when we walked into that room, walked up onto that stage, I had to tuck that in and show that it's okay. I can do this. These are people just trying to learn, trying to experience. And through that, after we kind of sat down, I got to feel out the room. I got to kind of know my audience. And we got talking. It became very natural, just like when Seth and I film.
And I do remember a singular moment as well. When we sat down, we grabbed each other's hands, mm-hmm. and I felt the nerves go down exponentially, mm-hmm. as I'm sure you felt as well. Mm-hmm. Us being there together, helping each other, lifting each other, is so crucial. The most stressful thing, I would say, and it wasn't stressful, but it was just the the concern for my environment to mm-hmm. make sure that everyone around me was okay, mm-hmm. was the most important thing for me. That's making sure tea was okay, because with big crowds, she doesn't do too well with them. And so I was constantly, and I almost to the point of being annoying, asking her, you doing okay? Mm-hmm. I asked her so many times,
but that was good because that's what I needed.
It's true. And that was probably the most stress-inducing thing, but at the same time, it's who I am.
A rewarding thing at the same time.
Yeah, it's very rewarding to make sure that it was accomplished, that me making sure everyone was okay helped.
Yeah. We just plan to make this a yearly thing at FanX. We really want to work with the people there to make this possible to do a panel every year. Whether Quincy and Jason can and Harley can join us or not, we do hope that we can continue this and take this further to reach other people at other conventions. So this was a stepping stone into what we have planned for the future and that we want to do in the future.